Welcome to Icing Tonight as we take a look back at a fabulous season for the Telford Tigers. We'll also be having a chat to some of the players. So, coming up in tonight's show, we'll have a chat to Lubomir Korhon and Danny Rose. And we'll have highlights of games the Telford Tigers played in September when they faced Hull, Sheffield and Basingstoke. Silverthorne off the boards, gets the break, goes with it. Silverthorne puts it onto the back post. Puts it into the back post, and it goes forward from Macaulay Hayward, having the right hand over the top. Throwing it in, and Miller's going toe to toe, and he's got three or four headshots, and it drags him down. Still has it. Darbo being sort of marked out the game by Tom, and the shot comes from forward now. Bebrea with plant. Bebrea walks in, shoots,
and he looked up his own rebound and scores.
Zabo, and he's not happy about that. It was a late hit, the hit from behind, and you see the players. So welcome to Icing Tonight on Made in Birmingham. We're joined by, now, let's get the pronunciation of this right. Lubomir?
Lubomir.
Yeah. And then
the surname is Korhon.
Yeah. So a bit like Korhon. That just helps me to remember. Welcome to the studio. So how old were you when you started playing hockey?
I was 6 years old.
Okay. Yeah. How did you get into it, though? What was your first game or the first time you saw hockey?
I did, since I was 3 years old, I did figure skating.
Right, okay.
Because of my older sister. And when I was practicing as a figure skating, figure skater, I saw the hockey, the ice hockey practices with the young kids. And it amazed me, and I wanted to start to be a hockey player.
And that started at 6 years old. Did your parents take much convincing as you were doing figure skating that you wanted to make the move to hockey?
Yeah, my dad was for it, but my mom wasn't, because she thought it's a tough sport. I'd be injured a lot. But I wanted it so bad, so hard. So I wanted so much. So they did it for me.
And how did you get from playing at home to coming over to England? What was the journey that brought you here?
I had a season when I was stopped playing for a Czech for a top league.
Yeah.
And I didn't have a team till like November. I had a couple offer, but it wasn't a very good offer.
Okay.
And then suddenly I received the agent who is working for English teams.
Right.
They offered me to come here, and I said, yeah, why not? Like, it's going to be a nice experience. Should be a nice experience.
And how long ago was that?
It's 4 years ago.
And the first team you came to was?
Was Sheffield Steel Dogs.
And was it as good an experience as you thought it might be?
There was so many strange things happening in hockey, around the hockey, especially there. Like, comparing the Telford Tigers, it's more professional than the Sheffield Steel Dogs. But it was like, I really liked to play there.
How did you find the language barrier? Because with English being your second language, that must be pretty tough coming into not only a team, but also a society where everybody's speaking a different language.
This is sometimes hard, but on the other hand, when you're playing hockey, the ice rink and everything around hockey is universal language, and it's everywhere the same. So like, it was pretty easy on there at the ring. Sometimes like, there was a little bit barrier out of the ring, but the English people are helpful, so it was all right.
Fantastic. Right, now, we have a slow cooker in here.
Okay.
And this is the casserole of questions. And what we're going to do is, at random, pull a couple of questions out and see what you get, okay?
Okay.
So the first question that we have is, what are your favourite sweets?
My favourite sweets? Chocolate.
Your chocolate?
Yeah, I'm chocolate.
And do you eat a lot of chocolate?
I've got the period.
I think you're allowed a little bit. Right, let's get another one. Another question out of the
casserole of questions. Right. Have you been in any groups or uniformed organisations? This is things like the Scouts, or when you were little, were you in any groups or societies?
I had to be, because I grew up in the 80s and it was still the socialism, the communism system around the country. And we have to be in a group called Pioneer.
Okay.
It was like for since 6 to 10 years old pupils.
Yeah.
And we have to wear a uniform.
Right. And what sort of thing? Was it sort of like the Scouts? Where
it
you
was
went out
something
and...
so relevant as a Scouts. Yeah. We sometimes campaign again, but only the one thing was they already like tried to attract the small kids to a communism or socialism system.
Right. So it was almost like a conditioning system where they wanted to get you into certain beliefs, was it?
Yeah, a little bit.
Wow. Yeah. And then, so in your sort of teenage years, do you think that helped you in life, or what were your thoughts on having done that?
It was a little bit more like a scout, so it was nice to be. Sometimes we made some trips and we had to do something in a group. So this was a nice memory. But they were talking about how social system is good, like how we have to believe in this system. Sometimes they try to, but I had a parents who explained me more.
Now.
That's nice.
The next bit we have for you is the Keepy Uppy Challenge, okay? So we're going to invite you to come and stand over here, okay? We have a football, and we're challenging all the Telford Tigers to do as many Keepy Uppies as you can.
Okay.
All right? So there's the ball, okay? Just stand there and see how many times you can keep the ball up. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. He's good. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20. Good job. Lubomir, Korhon, thank you very much for chatting to us.
Thank you very much.
So welcome back to Icing Tonight. We're joined by defenceman Danny Rose. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Right, Danny, how did your hockey career or discovery of ice hockey start for you?
Well, my dad used to work at the Nottingham Ice Rink and got my brother into it, and then I went and watched my brother's first game and just fell in love with the game ever since.
So you started playing Nottingham. How old were you when you started playing?
I was 3.
Right.
When I started playing. So very young, little kid out on the ice just skating around. People are like, oh, who's that little kid skating around? And I was just on my own, just going around like,
owning the rink.
Yeah, just thinking I was like the next Panther or something, just going out there owning it. So.
And was that the drive to become a Panther as a little one?
Yeah, because they used to come on training and they used to help out in the old ice rink. And I used to be like, oh, wow, I want to be one of those. I want to be like come to the games and see all the people that were there and cheering. And I wanted to be part of that.
And when you sort of went up through your hockey career, as a British kid, I assume that parents were saying, well, hang on, you're going to need a job, you're going to need your education and balance everything, rather than throw 100% at it.
Yeah, my mum and my dad always said that my education always comes before hockey. And when I obviously hit, like, college and stuff like that, my parents were like, right, you need to get a job because we can't pay for hockey and stuff all the time now.
Fantastic. Right, let's get in the slow cooker to the casserole of questions and see what comes out for you. Look at the nerves on their faces, I love it. Right, you have got most embarrassing thing that's ever happened to you.
There's been a few. I would probably have to say when me and my family were out for dinner and they had it was like a little bay area and there was bars like in between.
Yeah.
So you can obviously look through to the next table. But I thought it'd be hilarious to put my head through the bars.
Right.
And then I got my head stuck when I was trying to get it out.
In a restaurant.
So, in a restaurant between my table and someone else's table.
So there's a family sitting there.
So my head
How old were you at this point?
I was about 7.
Right, okay.
But my head is with this family and my body is with my family. And all you can hear is me just screaming and crying. And just like, I can't get out. I'm stuck. And then everyone was just like round trying to help.
How did they get you out? Did it...
Luckily, they just like pulled me out. And,
right.
But I kind of like had to turn and twist. And...
I love that. Thank you. Right, let's see what else we've got in here. Bom, 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 bom. Favorite TV show to watch?
Ooh, favorite TV show to watch? It'd have to be Friends.
Okay.
I like Friends. I don't know why.
Just nice
probably,
bit of
probably
chilled.
Jennifer Aniston.
But, maybe. I can imagine that yeah, play a part in it.
I find that quite funny. I enjoy watching that. So.
Fantastic. Right, it's time for you to do the Keepy Uppy Challenge. So far
go.
On the board, Lumbo's the leader with 21. We have a football here. Right,
here we go.
There you go.
Let's hope I don't smash this.
Right. Yeah. Away you go, as soon as you're ready. One.
Oh, one! No!
You know that embarrassing moment we talked about earlier? Danny, that could be it. Thank you for
Thank
joining
you.
Us,
buddy. Cheers.
Now let's take a look at the highlights of the Telford Tigers when they took on the Hull Pirates in a pre-season friendly on September the 4th, 2016.
Now the teams line up. Referee Matthews takes to centre ice as the puck's about to drop on the Telford Tigers versus the Hull Pirates. Silverthorne wins the draw, gives it back to Clarkson, goes back to D. Zajac puts it up on the left wing to McEwen. A drive forward from Clarkson, McEwen's backing him up. Clarkson, up to the point. Shot comes in from Corey Goodison, who's playing in defence in Weaver's position.
Unusual.
And he's come up from the NIHL, playing with the experience of Sam Zajac, and that'll do him the world of good, lining up on the first line here with the Tigers tonight. Now, Hull on the break. Go up to the zone, and it's backhanded in by Gareth O'Flaherty. And then the puck goes around the board. Silverthorne gets turned over at the halfway line. Hull dumped the puck on target. It's Lasek that puts it towards the Tigers netminder between the pipes. He had a good game in his opening game last week and made some fantastic saves here at the Telford Ice Rink. Andre Raska looking good in Tigers shirts tonight as the Tigers break out from the back of the net.
Sam Zajac just done a very sensible thing. Just calmed the game down a bit to allow them to get a change in line.
Davis puts it off and it leaves Zajac on his own, but he tips it forward to Plant. Gets the pass on the right wing, drives forward, presses towards the net, passes it forward, and a tipping, a beautiful tipping for the first goal of the night. And that came in as Satek comes across the front, the shot comes across, the tipping angles the puck into the top corner, and once again the Telford Tigers off the mark nice and early. 1 minute and 12 seconds saw the first goal of the night, scored by Satek, assisted by Rick Plant, onto the back post.
Oh.
Satek gives it back to Zajac, and I thought for a minute he was going to lose possession. Clarkson to the back post, passes in front, Silverthorne puts it in the back of the net.
Yes.
The puck was clearly in, the light was on, and a strategy by the Hull defenceman pushed the net off. It can't be a goal if the net's off before the puck's in the back of it, but I think you'll see from that that long before he pushed the net off, the puck was in the back of the net. So that 53-second penalty expires as a power play goal is scored for the Telford Tigers, but still Tom Watkins has a man advantage for the next 1 minute and 24 seconds. Battling for possession on the boards there. Cycling the puck out of the corner. Heads over towards the net. Gets in the side netting, a drive forward from Matty Davis, and he battles his way and forces the puck past the netminder, and you can see the look in the netminder's face as Jordan Maher is amazed that Satek forced the puck under his body. Goal scored. Goal number three, even-handed. 17 minutes and 22 seconds.
Matty Davis just goes down and takes some applause. Pat on the head there from his captain.
Zajac back up to the point. Oh, just loses possession of the puck but manages to tip it in on the blue line. Silverthorne. Davis.
He goes
to the back post and it was the netminder that put him in for it. So Davis picks up the puck and it deflects from the netminder into the back of the goal. So a Telford Tigers power play goal scored at 22 minutes and 4 seconds, and I think that one's going to be credited to Matty Davis.
Matty Davis, yeah, his hat-trick goal. He took the shot along the ice and it deflected, as you say, off the Hull skate and into the back of the net.
Drives forward.
Oh, and he's taken out by Marcus Maynard.
And he's given a bit of an elbow back, and this is the sort of thing that can escalate sometimes when a team sees a game slip away from them. shot from Silverthorne and finds the top right-hand corner as he drove down. You can see the pressure coming as the Telford Tigers force their way down the play. It was generated for Keelan, put the puck across to Silverthorne, buys his time, waits, fires it home in the top right-hand corner for the fifth goal of the night for the Telford Tigers. A short-handed goal, and you were saying earlier, Alan, how they do step up the mark with the quick feet. They just had a line change.
Nathan cross ice at the moment.
Feeds it into the corner, gets it back, takes it back round the back of the net, looking for someone in the middle. Can't see anybody, so he circles round, switches sides, holds it, taking control. And there's Salem.
Salem shoots and scores. And Nathan Salem gets the first goal of the night for the Hull Pirates. A power play goal at 28 minutes and 55 seconds. Bringing the score to 5-1. There's still a comfortable cushion for the Telford Tigers, but when a team gets a goal, there's always a danger, Alan, that that can shift momentum slightly in favour of the other team. Tate. Tate drives forward on the right side, carries it over the blue line, gives it to Silverthorne, puts it to Clark, on the back post, who finishes it off by firing home in the back shelf. What a set play there. Silverthorne out to Tate, drives it down the right side, back to Silverthorne, powers his way in, sees, looks up, pulls the netminder to one side, passes the puck to Clarkson, who fires it home in the top shelf for a textbook sixth goal for the Telford Tigers. Scored on 32 minutes and 3 seconds. An even-handed goal for the Tigers. 6-1 the scoreline, 5 goals the cushion, and a fantastic execution. Stick down, but it was at chest height by Kirk, who's not the tallest of guys, so I don't think we've got any danger of a high stick there.
He's very Sam Zajac-ish, isn't he? He's in stature and style.
But leagues apart in natural ability to read the game.
Yeah.
That's what, you know, one of the things about Sam is his work rate and ability, but his knowledge to read of the game.
Ooh,
carry round, tries to get an empty net, and a backhanded shot from 56 to put it in the back of the net. And it was Lee Haywood, I think, that got the goal, which will cancel out the penalty. A power play goal for the Hull Pirates. A lot of traffic in front of the net. The netminder comes away. You've got a lot of open space. Everybody's scrapping around to get on the puck, and it was Lee Haywood that managed to get the backhand of his stick to the puck, put the puck in the back of the net. 6-2 the scoreline. Haywood the scorer. Time of goal, 34 minutes and 20 seconds in the second period. Telford Tigers 6, Hull Pirates 2.
Maybe some fisticuffs again. That can turn a game around.
Yeah. It depends who comes off worse for it, because last time it was Telford. Right, a drive forward. McEwen fires it home.
Word,
and that was
a
backhand from McEwen into the top right-hand corner as we look at it. Left-hand corner from where Mar is standing. And if his old man is watching this, Doug, that was an impressive move. McEwen, 71 for Telford, drives it forward. 35 minutes and 52 seconds was the time. 2.5 minutes left in the second period. Plant delays it back to Silverthorne. Fires on the net.
Satek!
And fires it home in the back of the net. A great save to be set fair to Jordan Maher. Saves the puck. The puck drops down into the slot. Satek skating at full pelt towards the puck. Winds up. Fires the puck in the top right-hand corner with a beautiful finish there from Satek, putting the Telford Tigers 8-2 up. And officials in the building is entitled to a drink if he sees you fall on your derriere.
Roy's taking it. Oh, now we've got a breakaway from Hull.
Shoots and straight into the body. Raska makes a save. He gets the rebound and then fires it in the back of the net. That was unfortunate for the netminder. But a drive forward from Bonner. Takes the puck forward, fires it into Raska. He made the save. The puck drops down in front of him. And then Bonner picks it up, fires it through the five hole. You can still see Raska trying to establish his balance to get on his feet. And the puck trickled underneath him as he fell backwards into the net, taking it off its moorings, by which time the puck was already in the back of the net. Hull Pirates 3, Telford Tigers 8. Skates it out. Pulls across play. Goodison. Forward to Clarkson. Shoots and finds the top corner.
Top right.
A beautiful finish. I think Maher got a little touch to it with his glove, and you saw it take a bit of a change of direction, but Clarkson's puck still found it into the top right-hand corner of the net as we look at it, and that puts the Telford Tigers back with the 7-goal lead. And where are we at? Sorry, 6-goal lead. 34 seconds after the whole game. Goal. So 42 minutes and 34 seconds sees a goal for Martin Clarkson.
Martin Clarkson.
No.
He was a goalkeeper a few years ago.
I knew that.
And Doug Clarkson.
Doug Clarkson plays the body into the boards. And now a drive from Davis. He's got Clarkson with him, gives it Clarkson, who shoots and scores into the top right-hand corner again. So, Doug Clarkson, top right-hand corner, beautifully executed from a fantastic pass from Davis on 45 minutes and 17 seconds, puts the Tigers 10 goals to Hull's 3. I think that's the first time I've seen double figures in a long time here in Telford.
First time double figures. I'm just looking at my notes. It's the second hat-trick. So we've got Davis on a hat-trick and now Clarkson on a hat-trick.
Do you remember that Fools and Horses episode where they had the paint from the front of the trains and to paint the Chinese takeaway and it glowed in the dark? Yes, yes. Tate passes across to Silverthorne, who fires it home in the right-hand side. Tate loses foot in behind the net and takes the whole player out, but not intentionally. It was Tamar behind the net. But what a beautiful pass from Tate and a fantastic execution in the right hand side. And you've been spoiled for choice on goals tonight. 11 goals to 3, 11th goal scored at 47 minutes and 35 seconds. Beautiful pass and even better execution right there from Jason Silverthorne.
Textbook goal. It's becoming a bit of a rout now. I think the Hull legs have given up.
Yeah.
I just look at our cameraman there, Jim Shaw. He's going to have a good job editing all this into a programme.
Maybe we should start for you.
Please do.
Now, drive forward. Brittle shoots and scores.
He
picked it up. They won the draw. He backhanded it through. Luke Brittle, quick hands, straight into the slot. Fires it home for goal number 12 for the Telford Tigers. Scored by 77, Luke Brittle. Time of the goal, 53 minutes and 56 seconds.
And now we're seeing a good spread of players getting on the score sheet. It's not going just to the hat-trick guys.
Puck drops it at the end of the game. It finishes with the Telford Tigers 12, the Hull Pirates 3. Fantastic performance from Tom Watkins' men. And no shadow of a doubt that Tom will be really happy with his pre-season challenge game preparation.
Absolutely. He's lost one and he's won the rest. So it's good news. He's made a few changes.
Now it's time to take a look at the action of the Telford Tigers when they took on Sheffield on the 18th of September 2016.
Tate and Zajac. Now, it's the first time these pairings have played together on D. Yeah. As the puck drops, Clarkson ends up with it, sends it back to Zajac, across to Warren Tate, steps up to the blue line, looks for the stretch pass. The interception of number 33 for the Steel Dogs, Bossas, didn't get to the puck, and now it's deep in the end zone. Comes in front, Silverthorne gets the shot away, the netminder tucks, and it drops down in front of the goal, but very nearly the Tigers get their first attempt on goal, 15 seconds in, and now Sheffield take it down the other end, make a shot, and it's being carried out by Silverthorne across the hill, and it's an offside call against Clarkson, I think, on the far wing. Calvert cycles forward, a lunge by Warren Tate, gets the puck forward to Silverthorne, on to Clarkson on the right wing. Hill comes in front of the slot. Good work and hustling there for Thomas Barry for the defence of the Sheffield Steel Dogs. Tate, he lined it up and it didn't quite, it bobbled a little bit.
Zajac
shoots, and I think it took a deflection from either Hill or Silverthorne. The shot came from Sam Zajac in the high slot area, and you'll see the celebrations go as the Telford Tigers celebrate their first goal on 5 minutes and 8 seconds. So at 5:08, the Telford Tigers, off the mark on the scoring, scored. And we'll wait to see who's credited to in terms of deflection, but the play was generated by Sam Zajac.
Absolutely, Tate sort of faked the shot. I thought he was going to let it rip, pushed it across to Zajac, who put one in. Maybe a bit pinballish, but let's hear who got it.
Yeah, it was credited to 22. Jason Silverthorne got the deflection or the rebound from Sam Zajac Scott's shot, but that puts them on the scoreboard at 5 minutes and 8 seconds. Tigers 1, Sheffield 0. Backhand, Davis drives forward into the end zone now. Satek hovering in front of the high slot area. Davis tries to paddle it on the backhand, goes around as far as the Zamboni corner. And then Satek generates the play. Sheffield clear it out into neutral ice, picked up by 69. That's a drive forward now from Myrna.
Beautiful
shoots, and it comes across, and the retaliation from Bossas, I think, was the scorer. And that goes 33. Bossas assisted by the drive in the corner from Myrna, and the answer to Telford's goal comes some 32 seconds later. At 5 minutes and 40 seconds, the Sheffield Steel Dogs pull it back to 1-1.
Well, that was short-lived, wasn't it? And we see this time and time again, the Tigers sat back on that lead and they've paid the price. I think Bossas, this is his second season, I think, with the Steel Dogs.
Yeah, so here we go. Second period action. Telford Tigers take on the Sheffield Steel Dogs. 1-1 the scoreline. Referee Matthews indicates to the bench, drops the puck. There's a bit of a turn and a bit of a rugby scrum in the centre circle there, but coming out of the face-off with the puck was Briscoe for Sheffield, and now a drive forward by number 42, which is Smith. Sends it around the board. Sam Zajac tries to clear it out. Remember, Sheffield on the power play. Puck gets dumped down the ice. Scott tries to find Satek. Pushing and shoving on the puck. Now there's a 3-on-2. Satek to the back post to Davies. Chilton scores. And look at the celebration on Satek's face. He's on his knees, both hands in the air, punching Highwood towards the sky as you see him battle to try and force that puck past Headley. I think at first he thought Headley had gone on it, and I think it drifted, either bounced from his padding or drifted in that small gap between Headley and the post. And as he went past, he saw the puck drop into the back of the net and gave it the football style on your knees celebration as he clutches his fist towards the air to put Telford in front. 27 minutes and 46 seconds.
You see the amount of celebration shows what that goal means.
Yeah.
It tells you what this game is about and how close it actually is.
It's a tied-up game. Both teams have stepped up the pace, and Telford have got themselves on the board. Davies hustles on the corner, cycles up to the high slot area.
Oh,
walks in, fakes it, the defenseman backs off, and he just took his time and beautifully tapped it into the left-hand side of Hadfield. And to be fair to the netminder, what you saw the Sheffield defence do then is they peeled away, picking up a man, thinking that Davies was going to pass it off. But then Davies said, hang on a minute, the defence are peeling away. I'm just going to happily walk my way in, stop it, and do what I need to do.
It was like the parting of the waves, the parting of the sea. That was the door just opened up for him, and he went, took the shot. 3-1 Telford Tigers. Ben Morgan just loses out on the blue.
And now Macaulay Hayward drives through the right side, picks up the puck, cycles it right in the backhand.
What a goal!
And standing on the back post there, I'm just trying to see who it was that scored it. You've got Kalina there, but it was finished off by McEwen. Doug, if you're listening, a fantastic finish. Macaulay Hayward drives down the right side, the defenseman pushes away from him, he carries the puck just past and then backhands it across to McEwen, stood on the back post, who fires it into the back of the net. And here we are, goal number 4 for the Tigers, scored on 33 minutes and 55 seconds.
I apologise for my enthusiasm there, but I've watched Macaulay Hayward transist from a guy on the fringes to he scored last night, and what he did there was out of this world. All the way down, spun on his backhand, give it to McEwen.
Clarkson shoots, and McEwen stood on the back post waiting to just fire it into the back of the net. Now the puck cycling just behind the net, and now a drive forward by Sheffield, taken off them by Tate, and a big hit there, finished this time by Briscoe.
What I said in the last break, Paul, you know, when Telford scored a third goal, Sheffield got
Kirk,
what they do, but Kirk's going
walks
in,
his way in, carries it around the net, tries the wraparound, and an amazing wraparound from Kirk, the young guy, just carries it around the back of the net with a complete wraparound. Rasker pulls to the post, drives, and he's so quick, he's got long reach, much like Adam Taylor's, and a beautifully executed, retaliated goal on 34 minutes and 36 seconds, only seconds after that fantastic goal by McEwen, set up by Macaulay Hayward. Kirk says, have a bit of that.
If you're a hockey fan, doesn't matter who you support, those last two goals, my reaction, I do apologise for it, but I was equally as excited about that last goal, because blimey, for these young guys to be going out and doing stuff like that, absolutely astounding.
Really making their mark on the league. There was a time when British guys were reserved for the bottom end, and it's them that are making all the plays on both teams tonight.
And I was just commenting, what has Sheffield got to do here? And there you go. You
that's
got the
what they
got
to do. We get the third period underway at Telford Ice Rink. So now, just takes it behind the net and loses possession. Whether the ice was sticky or the determination of Silverthorne putting him under pressure.
Cardiff were the big team there when they joined the instant promotion from the second division to the first division to the Premiership, as it was then. And I know Doug McEwen was instrumental in that.
Battle in the corner.
McEwen, Hope and...
shot! And at number 33, Bossas steps up from the high slot, walks in on that power play, 9 seconds left with the man advantage, picks his shot, makes the wrist shot and fires it home for the Sheffield Steeldogs. Now, you remember what we said about the goal? The next goal could be the game maker. 4-3 the scoreline. One goal in it now. Comes down the middle lane. Picked up by Satek, shoots!
Over the top!
And you saw... To be fair, you saw Bricko push him in, the stick comes across the front, and then the puck, as you say, scooped up and goes high, and then in front,
and
it drops too, and there's that celebration again from Satek. Skates in front, the puck drops at his feet, and he fires it into the back of the net. So the Telford Tigers now sit on 5-3, and I think there'll be a sigh of release from the Telford coaching staff as they go in front 5-3 at 54 minutes and 24
Did
seconds.
Satek pick that one up or Kalina?
I thought it was Satek that scored. Will Telford put the nail in the coffin by putting another one in the goal, or will this spur Sheffield on?
And this is what I mentioned earlier.
Oh, big hit from McEwen there, taking Bell off his feet, and you can see that he wasn't happy about that at all, so the retaliation might come back in the other direction.
Patterson's going in now. We've seen a bit
backhanded
of Sheffield
tip up and over from Myrna.
A bit of Sheffield of old starting to shine through here. A bit of fisticuff sort of pushing and shoving and argy. And the shot there from Myrna goes wide.
Shot this time from the point from Ross. And he finds the top right-hand corner. Look at the celebration on his face. The puck comes to him. He fires it for the top right-hand corner. Beating Rashko and goes over his shoulder. We've got a game on our hands, Alan. 5-4 the scoreline. Time of the Sheffield goal is 55 minutes and 52 seconds, just like in the first period. Now, I think as this setup comes, if he's going to go, he's going to go now. Looking at the Sheffield netminder, he looks over to the bench. And it has to make a save there as Phil Hill gets the turnover. And if that's going to make you nervous, if nothing does.
Sheffield come. He's looking. No. It's turned around in neutral ice again. And
Sheffield need to own possession if the netminder's to go off.
They're going to try and set up. He should follow the playoff here. Yeah. Watch.
As soon as it hits the halfway line, no, he ain't going anywhere. He's not confident that they're going to keep possession, and they don't. Offside. Now, there'll be a quick... Now, the linesmen are going to get some grief here because... Now, Kalina comes in against Bossas. There's a bit of argy-bargy against the boards. Now, the reason that there's so much frustration... Look, as camera two picks up the referee, you can see Bell and Wood chirping at the referee. The reason they're so cross is Kirk was in the offside position, but it was a Telford player that put the puck back into their own end. So it wasn't a Sheffield player that forced the puck over. So actually, as the letter of the rules state, it wasn't offside.
But the argy-bargy started because Bossas shot the puck a couple of seconds.
Now,
the whistle went.
Now, 69 Marina just touched his stick on Davis's visor as if to incite him. Now, the referee now needs to get a grip on this game.
Now take a look at the highlights of the Telford Tigers versus Basingstoke when the two sides met each other on the 25th of September 2016.
Got two big netminders tonight, Hadalovsky in the nets for
Davis the takes the centre, wins it, goes back, Clarkson puts it back to Sam Zajac. Warren Tate off the boards up to Satek. Tate, who played in defence for Hull, started his first few games here in Telford as a winger, and since Jonathan Weaver's been out, Warren Tate stepping back up to play defence alongside Sam Zajac. Puck goes in behind the net, tries to get the pass out in front, and Telford already steaming forward as Hadalowski's covering the puck to stop the play with the first save of the night. Now Telford come in and walk in, a shot comes in from Jones, goes wide, deflects into the corner, Silverthorne sort of locked out, battling, pushing and shoving to regain the puck from Lackey.
Lackey's working hard on those corners.
Certainly. Backhand from Silverthorne goes in the front, the puck goes into the air,
and
now
go.
It's
going to
go. This
here
is because Basingstoke will perceive that as a late challenge. There's some pushing and shoving, there's a player lying on top of Silverthorne in front of us. You can see the linesman there with him as if to say, keep cool.
The but that's still Baird on his back again. That's twice in one shift.
The defenceman will always look after the netminder. Basingstoke walk in, shoot for the post.
Thomas
just
Carpenter
drops behind the post and then comes out into the boards. You can see that Davis got pinned against the boards there by Silverthorne. Telford defence working hard to clear the puck out the zone, but Balmer keeping it in for the Basingstoke Bison on the power play.
I notice on the shorthanders, Telford don't play it as a shorthanded when it's loose like that. They play the box when it's a slack setup, but when it's tight like this, they go out
Karpov
and challenge.
Up to Balmer, back to Karpov, walks in from the high slot, shoots, and it took a deflection from his own player, Danny Davis. Took the puck, deflected it into the corner there. Karpov there, and Davis tried to cycle the puck round. It goes into the Farrelling corner where Jarolin picks it up, sends it up to Balmer on the point, back down to Jarolin.
Back to Karpov.
Goes onto the back post. Karpov up to Balmer. Shoots, takes a deflection, a backhanded nudge, nearly found the net for Mob. And it's the third attempt this time coming in, I believe, from Danny Davis. Danny Davis or Karpov, one of the two is in front of the slot and just popped in the back of the net. So the first goal of the night, a power play goal, 8 minutes and 34 seconds for the Basingstoke Bison, cancelling out that high stick penalty. You can see some pushing and shoving, Davis trying to free the puck up. Davis pushes forward. Clarkson dumps it corner to corner. Goes down ice. Reynolds clears it off the boards. Up to Zajac. Zajac tips it forward. Silverthorne backhands down to Clarkson, who fires it. It only gets as far as the shorts of Silverthorne. Behind the net. Passes in front. And it was passed in front by Matty Davis. Picked up by Clarkson, who finds the top right-hand corner. The netminder firmly placing that at the door of these defencemen. As the pass comes from the back of the net, I believe it was from Matty Davis.
And look at the time.
As a result, it comes out. Clarkson picks up the puck, fires it into the top right-hand corner, and there is 1 second remaining on the period, bringing Telford back into the game. A power play goal for both teams puts 1-1 on the clock, but a great time for Tom Watkins' men to equalise, Alan.
Absolutely, as the buzzer goes for the end of the first period, you couldn't have timed that much better. When you're commentating, you get to think, well, I haven't mentioned his name in a while. And you,
or how often you're saying certain players' names really makes a difference in terms of what Matthews. You can expect from those players. So the second period, the puck drops, goes back to the Basingstoke D. You see them pass D to D, put it up ice. There's a call for icing. Washed off there by the attacking players. And now the puck's come out into neutral ice. Satek takes a hit on the turn there from Lack. Sort of rolled him against the boards. And now Karpov
wheeling round as he does brilliantly.
Lack driving him towards the boards. Deflected off the boards there by Reynolds. Karpov trying to go through, and Sam Zajac skates right into him as if to say, you ain't doing that on my watch.
Absolutely.
Puck comes around, drops into the feet.
Never seems to put a foot wrong, Sammy Zajac.
Satek takes it back, and this time Lack tries to pin him with his left leg.
Thanks for your messages on social media. I thought I just won another one, but apparently Lionel Messi's just started following me.
Oh, has he?
Yeah. And he got 49 followers. Do you think it's a genuine account?
Maybe, maybe not. Now there's a bit of a battle in front of the Zamboni gate. You can see the pushing and shoving for the puck there just behind the net. And they're all over the floor, but the puck comes out and it's retrieved by Basingstoke's Jarolin. Carries it up ice, sent back down into the end zone, and a goal scored by Reynolds as he shoots and fires it from against the boards. I was just looking at the players' setup. Reynolds lets the cannon go. You saw Rashka drop, and then the red light's on. The puck beating him. Reynolds putting the second goal of the night for the Basingstoke Bison. A great shot that was passed by Jarolin as he passed it up the ice, received the shot, fired it home and did the damage. So the second goal for Basingstoke, 25 minutes, 22 seconds, scored by number 7, Kurt Reynolds.
Here we go!
Zajac locking out, and they're going toe-to-toe, and you can see him coming across the top. Zajac hanging on to him, getting back up again, and this time I think it's Lack coming across the top with the right hand.
And
you can see Zajac up and over, pulling his shirt over his head and going with the uppercut underneath, and he's not letting the linesman come in, as every time they drop down, they lock out. The two of them look a little tired now and ease off, but both getting some good right hands in as they dance around a little bit. It's Alan Lack versus Sammy Zajac in front of the net. It all kicked off as a result of the play in front. Both helmets are up, they're locking out, and now they drop onto the ice and the linesman will split them in. Both of them ragdolling each other up and over, right hands coming under the shirt into the face of the opposite player. Lack definitely had the advantage in the first sort of few strokes of that, and then Zajac, I'd give him the points for the second half.
And Reynolds is going with it. Well, they're pushing and shoving.
Switches, Warren Tate goes in front, Hills holding his feet in front of that netminder.
Oh, what a huge hit from Hill in the corner.
And that was on Antonov, I believe.
It was on Antonov, and he knocked
but
him on his
Hill's got side. A few issues with Reynolds as well, because we mentioned earlier. Connolly, back up to the point. Got to remember, Basingstoke have got a man advantage. We can't be dealing with cheap plays round Hadalovsky's end, taking away the momentum of this Basingstoke power play, Alan.
Absolutely, and the Basingstoke are
Reynolds,
calming it down.
Off to the left side. Game. Antonov tries to cut inside, but well
there.
Read by Dan Scott. McEwen picks it up, goes, switches sides behind the net,
got
walks it in. Davis goes for the back post, shoots and scores! The goal created there by McEwen, picked up the puck, buys his time. You see Davis come skating into the back post. McEwen biding his time. You said he's got no passing option. He puts it into the space. You see Matty Davis then skate after the puck into that space, pick it up and put it in the top right-hand corner. Once again, the Telford Tigers scoring right at the end of the period. 8 seconds left and it brings it back to a tied 2-2 game, Alan.
Well, he had no options to start with and he held the play up. McEwen
just waited.
McEwen was so professional. He slowed it down, stopped.
You saw Davis driving on that back post and fire it home. We've seen some scrapping. We've seen some couple of goals. Hadalovsky instigates to Karpov in the centre. The puck's dropped. Karpov wins it. Goes back to Baird. D to D pass up ice. And here we go in the third period action of the Telford Tigers versus the Basingstoke Bison. Cross-eyes pass to McEwen right in front of us here at the commentary
crowd
point.
Woke up. Now McEwen
walks it in! Oh, and he lays it in! And it was Doug Clarkson that picked up. It was the same partnership as the last goal. McEwen takes it round. Look at the Tigers fans celebrate there. McEwen comes round the back of the net. From there, the puck comes across. Hadalovsky is down, face down on the ice. You saw McEwen drive round, tried to get towards the goal. It was Doug Clarkson that was in that slot area. Sam Zajac grabs hold of it, deflects it off the boards, goes up ice. Now, comes out into neutral ice. Goes cross ice. Gets as far as Barker.
We're into the last 30 seconds.
Yep.
Basingstoke haven't got the opportunity to get the netminder off. They've got to break out and they're being pinned into their own end. Silverthorne working.
Backhand, Jensen scores! Jason Silverthorne puts the puck in the back of the net with 23 seconds left to play. What a goal, what a time to score it. Out of the slot, on the backhand, fires it in the top shelf. And we were saying about Hadalovsky, that'll be it for him next.
It's going to be a good end to the weekend for Tom Watkins, man, after the draw last night.
Certainly
and the loss
does.
On penalties.
Reynolds holds the puck in, drops it down on the boards. Fans are on their feet, chanting.
Down, and that's it.
Now the puck drops down. We have a quick look at the fans up on the balcony now as they raise their feet. So what a fantastic September the Telford Tigers had to get the season off to a great start. Next week, we'll be having a look at the games played in October and we'll be having a chat to two more of the Telford Tigers, including Jason Silverthorne and Corey McEwen. Join us next week on Icing Tonight. Silverthorne off the boards, gets the break, goes with it. Silverthorne puts it onto the back post.
Oh,
Hill, who shoots and scores. Zajac puts it into the back post. And it goes forward from McCauley. Haywood having the right hand over the top, throwing it in. And Miller's going toe to toe. And he's got three or four headshots and then drags it down. Still has it. Szabo being sort of marked out the game by Tom. And the shot comes from Trump forward now. Bebrea with Plant. Bebrea walks in, shoots.
And he looks up his own rebound and scores.
Szabo, and he's not happy about that. It was a late hit, the hit from behind. And you see the players.